All right, thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen. Let's give the wonderful presentation a round of applause. Thank you again, Sandra, for the wonderful introduction. Good afternoon, I'm Carol, Mr. C. Henson from WHUR 96.3. We have a show called The Time Tunnel every Saturday morning from 9 to 1. Anybody listen to that? All right. It's my pleasure to be here with you once again. You know, I enjoy this so very much, and this is my second year, and hopefully will not be the last year. Our theme this afternoon is The Greatest, with help from the music of George Benson and Prince. Let's give that wonderful theme another round of applause. And you know, without good people at the leadership role, anything that the Department of Aging does is important because they have a great leader. She's a great friend of mine. And at this time, I'd like to introduce to you and bring to the stage, not really introduce to you because she's a good friend. I feel like I know her and I think you will too. The director of the DC Office on Aging, Ms. Laura Newland.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. C. Good afternoon. How is everybody? Oh, come on. How is everybody? Listen, we are so excited to have you all here today. I want to start off by thanking a few folks. I want to thank our Senior Service Network, all of our grantees to help provide our services to seniors in the community. I want to thank our Cameo Club, all of the ladies who have competed in this competition for the past several years, and they're the ones who put this show together and make this such a great day for everybody. I want to thank Ms. Romaine Thomas, I don't see her out here, but the chair of our Commission on Aging. They provide advice to us on what we can do better as the DC Office on Aging, and to the mayor on how to make the district the best place in the world for people to age and live. I also want to thank our very own Deputy Mayor for Health and Human Services, Hai-Suk Chung, who's here. Thank you very much, Deputy Mayor, for joining us today. So listen, today's theme is The Greatest. That's the greatest screamer. Congratulations, all right. So today's theme is The Greatest, and I love that theme because when we talk about aging, redefining aging, what does it mean to grow older? I love my job, and it's because in my job, I have examples every single day where people are saying, growing older does not mean just getting old. So today you are gonna see 8 wonderful contestants who are gonna show you the meaning of what it means to be the greatest, living your greatest life, living your best life, and that aging is living, right? That's what this means. Aging is living, and we want to help spread that message. I want to thank you all for supporting all of the women here today who are competing. It is no small feat to get on this stage and to compete in front of all your friends and family. And I got to say, we're going to crown a 2017 Miss Senior DC today, but you know all the women here on the stage, they're all winners. So there's going to be only one 2017 Miss Senior DC, but I love that we have so many people here in the District of Columbia who are willing to say, let me tell you my story about what it means to live a great life, right? And they are all examples of what it means to be the greatest. They're public servants, they're mothers, they're wives, and they're just, I mean, you're going to get a chance to meet them today. They are wonderful, all right? And so we are so thrilled to have you here today to celebrate with us and join us in cheering these ladies on. I want to be able to hear you. You got to get amped up, all right? And so stick with us today. Thank you so much, and enjoy the show.
At this time, you know, I just want to say that Mayor Muriel Bowser knew what she was doing when she appointed Laura Newland, didn't you? Let's give another round of applause. And the mayor told me that when we were together at Baloo, she said, I'm really happy about this appointment. Thank you again, Director Newland. The DC Commission on Aging chairperson is my good friend. I call her my girlfriend. I hope my girlfriend doesn't get upset with me, but You can laugh about that, come on. But I call her my other lady friend. She is a wonderful, wonderful person. DC Commission on Aging chairperson who serves as the advisor to the mayor and the office on aging on issues concerning older adults in the community. Let's welcome her warmly to the stage. My good friend, I want to introduce Romaine Thomas, Ms. Romaine Thomas.
And to prove that, I'm going to give Mr. C a hug and a kiss. Let me say good evening to everyone. I guess it's almost evening. To all of you gathered here for this wonderful, wonderful program. So just give yourselves a round of applause for being here because you made a great choice to come. As he said, my name is Romaine B. Thomas, the chairwoman for the DC Commission on Aging. And it is my pleasure to greet you on behalf of the commission. This body of dedicated persons, they're appointed by the mayor from all eight wards, and all eight wards are represented. Legislation tasks the commission with advocating to the mayor, the director, and city council, as well as the public. Also, we're thankful for the many commissioners and also former commissioners. So if you're here, also stand. But the bottom line is to support our seniors and to see that they have good health care and to help them to become independent and to see that they are protected, respected, and live with dignity. Give us a round of applause for that, okay? Because all of us can help with that task. As you know, we live in a youth-obsessed culture, and growing old is the ultimate challenge. This program today demonstrates how to meet the challenge of aging with great energy and willpower. It's an opportunity to change the dynamics of aging with a joyful and exciting celebration of life. And it's also an opportunity to see how we can move forward mentally and physically with a positive attitude. So this program brings beauty and grace to all of us, and we all believe in what we can do together. In closing, let me give thanks to the mayor for supporting senior programs that mattered and also the deputy mayor. Also, I want to extend a special recognition to Director Newland and her energetic, talented, and creative team and staff. Finally, let's recognize the Cameo Club. These gracious, right, let's give a round of applause, all of our Cameo members. Let's have them to stand too, because some of them are up front, but some are in other parts of the auditorium. Give them a round of applause. They're so special. In fact, I'm so happy to be a part of that because it is indeed a great sisterhood. Finally, let me say to you that this is a great opportunity to come together and to work together on behalf of seniors in this city. So enjoy the afternoon or the evening as we go into the evening, because it does make a difference for all of us. Take care, enjoy.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to introduce the persons who are tasked with judging this contest, rating, of course, each one of the individuals for elegance, grace, poise, and inner beauty in all four categories. First, let me introduce the chairperson, Ms. Sandra Hunter. She's the judge's chairperson. She's a native Washingtonian, retiree of Verizon. She believes she has been truly blessed and spends much of her time providing volunteer services to many others. She's been a volunteer for various senior organizations for many, many years. Please give our judge's chairperson, Ms. Sandra Hunter, a round of applause. Our first judge is James, I love this name, Jazzy Hughes. You like that? James Jazzy Hughes. Now listen to this, he's a choreographer, a tap dancer, and a tap dance instructor. James Hughes has been teaching a knock on wood since 2004. He's the artistic director and choreography for the tap dance group, The Lunch Bunch. The Lunch Bunch has become very popular in the DC metropolitan area. Please give a round of applause for James Jazzy Hughes. The next judge is Alvanus, I think I pronounced that right, Alvanus, Ms. Cribbs. I'm sorry, say it again? Alvanetta, thank you. Alvanetta Cribbs. Alvanetta is a native of Ohio, now living in Washington, D.C. She attended Youngstown State University, has been married for 31 wonderful years. And she has been at Georgetown University for about 4 months, so she can count many blessings that have been bestowed on her. So she thanks God every second day, and so do I. Her favorite saying is enjoy each moment. Let's give her a round of applause. Our next judge, ladies and gentlemen, is Deborah Robinson. Now, Deborah is a native Washingtonian, once again, and a retired DC public school education teacher. She completed a BA degree at Teachers College and an MS degree at the George Washington University. She's a Delta Sigma Theta, okay? Remember that sorority? She enjoys participating in initiatives with Help Those in Need. She also enjoys assisting students with their academic development as well as spending time with family and friends. Please welcome Judge Deborah Robinson. Our next judge is Lillian Pope Barry Lillian, a native of Indiana, retired from the Department of Defense after 36 years of service. She has 2 children, 5 grandchildren, and 2 great-grandchildren. Lillian grew up in a home of musicians. Her mother and father were, of course, both professionals, and her siblings either sang or played instruments. Listen to this, she studied piano, organ, and vocal music at the Ball State Teachers College and the University of Maryland. Lillian has attended Northeastern Presbyterian Church for more than 40 years and served as an assistant organist and pianist. Please welcome our next judge, Lillian Pope Barry Lillian. And now for the people who are kind of going to be tabulating, making sure that they keep all the numbers right. You all know about numbers, don't you? DC Lottery, you know what I'm saying. Now, this is a little different. The tabulators are very important. Our first tabulator is Rebecca Dorsch Brown, a native of Camden, Alabama. Graduated from Johnson C. Smith and has a BA in accounting and economics. And upon graduating from college, she began a career as an accountant with the U.S. Department of Housing and Urban Development in Washington, D.C. And after 35 years of working in various accounting, budgeting, and fiscal management positions at HUD, the Federal National Mortgage Association, the District of Columbia, and the Department of Treasury, Rebecca retired. And so let's give her a wonderful round of applause. Our second tabulator is Tony Akan, born in Lagos, Nigeria, to a Nigerian father and an American mother. He came to the U.S. in 1996, studied at our own Howard University in 1997. Howard University, where he studied psychology and graduated in 2000. Moved to New York to work for a company, then moved back to Washington, D.C. in 2001, started working for the U.S. Census Bureau in 2002. Married to a wonderful Yoshika, I think I pronounced that right, Okan, and they have 2 boys who they love very much. So let's give a wonderful round of applause to our judges panel. And this lady that I'm about to introduce, it's a pleasure because she has been working hard. Every place I go, we were at Baloo last week, and just everything we do when it comes to the Department of Aging, she is there. She's just doing her thing. So we'd like to bring to the stage Miss Senior DC, Billy Laverne Smith.
Thank you.
Just a slight thing here. We want to make sure that the previous winners get acknowledged, and this is always a great honor for me to do that, because everybody up here is a winner as far as I'm concerned. We thank you so much for attending. I think you as a beautiful audience should give yourselves a round of applause. You're wonderful. Thank you. The first contestant, or not even a contestant, the first winner is from 1992. Her name is Doris Thomas. Let's give her a round of applause. Once again, these are previous queens from 1999, Thelma Morgan. Let's give her a round of applause. Man, these ladies are looking good, aren't they, I tell you. From 2002, Miss Daisy Savage. I don't know how I'm gonna do this one. But she is my dear friend. I love her so much, and we work together so closely. From 2005, Sandra Beers, Miss Senior DC. Let's give all these ladies a round of applause. From 2006, the lovely Miss Ann Thomas. I hope they don't put no phone numbers on here for me to call them. You can laugh about that, that's all right. Miss Lucille Watson from 2007. Let's give her a round of applause. Well, this is Miss Sheila Poole, Miss Senior DC 2010. Welcome. You won that year, didn't you? Miss Emma Ward, let's give a round of applause. Oh man, we getting up here. These ladies, I tell you. Miss Senior DC for 2014, Miss Toni Jackson. For many, many years. And she's always there when it comes to just helping out and doing wonderful things. Miss Senior DC 2015, the lovely Miss Wendy Bridges. Let's give her a round of applause. Well, you can do better than that. I think all of them should get a wonderful round. Once again, this is the Miss Senior DC pageant for 2017. This is my second year here, and it's just been a great, great, great experience. Yes, last week we were at Baloo for the Senior Symposium. We had a great time. Anybody at the Senior Symposium last week? Mm-hmm. A lot of great information from a lot of people that were telling you good things to do. As my father used to say, age ain't nothing but a number. Let me hear y'all say that. Age ain't nothing but a number. One more time, age ain't nothing but a number. Now I feel better as old as I am. Okay, we're gonna begin with our first segment of the competition. The contestants will be scored on their talent, and I should note that talent is worth 30% of their scoring for this afternoon. Oh, amazes me how these ladies come up with these ideas. And we have to change props, so, you know, they said go out there and stall, but I don't want to do that. I'm just going to turn on the next performer, because she is very, very, very creative. She has original creative movement to the dance, Michael Jackson's The Way You Make Me Feel. Michael, we celebrated, of course, you know, his passing just recently. So I want you to put your hands together and welcome our next contestant, our next performer to the stage, Patricia Raglan, contestant number two. Including the judge is looking for, and you're enjoying yourselves. I can tell by your enthusiasm and your round of applause. Thank you so much once again for giving us time to put this whole thing together. The Department of Aging did one heck of a great job. They do great with all of their events. Thank you, Mayor Muriel. We appreciate you. Yeah. Well, they say that the next contestant might be after my job. I don't know why they said that. And she wants to be a radio host. Yeah, I know. I better watch out. That's what she said. And she performs a skit on WFRJ Radio. And she's doing her thing. So this is contestant number three. She gives excellent advice on how you can help others. Watch.
Top of the morning to you. I'm your host, Lady J, coming to you live from wherever you are, WFRJ 67.5 FM, the station where seniors rock and rule the world. Want to know what's on your mind, Lady J? Hello? Hello? Can you hear me? Can you hear me? I'm Andrea, and I want to talk about the immigration situation here in the United States. I am American, and I was born, raised, and educated in the United States, and my father served in the military. I want you to know that because I may not look like you or talk like you, I am American, and I love this country. Thank you, and I love your show, and I will hang up and hear what you have to say. Andrea, just want you to know we love America, we love you, and we thank you for that profound statement. God bless you, and God bless America. Lady J, who's on the line? Hi, sweetie. Dear Miss B, how you doing? I just want you to know I just had my 82nd birthday, but I'm gonna celebrate it like I was 28 years old. And you know what? I'm gonna go down to them clubs at 14th and U, and I'm gonna show them little young folks that wanna twerk and drive. I'm gonna show them how to do the atomic thaw. Only problem is, my husband, he don't wanna go. So I was wondering, Lady J, you think you could babysit my husband while I get my atomic thaw? I got to go now, cause he hungry, but I'll get you back tomorrow. Hi, sweetie. Well, Miss B, you know I love you. I want you to get your 28th birthday on. I can't babysit your husband, but you get that atomic dog going for me. That's all we got time for, ladies and gentlemen, and my seniors. But you keep that station on 67.5 WFRJ. Where seniors rule and rock the world. Let's take it home. Yeah. Shut up.
Well, I told you these ladies are putting a lot of energy into this situation, man. I'm so proud of them. And, you know, talking with them backstage is even more entertaining. Then you see them go out there and do their thing and everything. Let's give everybody a round of applause again. Wow. Well, you know, this next one, you know, are you ready for this? This is really going to be something. Our next contestant wants to kind of, what you say, face the music, as she sings her version of I Did It My Way. Note that, I Did It My Way. So I present to you Juanita Patterson, contestant number 4. Let's give it a round of applause.
And I'm
What has she got? If not herself, then she has not. To say the things she truly feels, and not the words one want to hear. Let the record show.
Thank you.
The pace here is different. Every act that comes out has something to offer, and I'm sure the judges are taking this into full consideration. Our next contestant will be presenting an original poem to the music of R. Kelly's I Believe I Can Fly. Anyone know that song, I Can Believe I Can Fly? Great song. But her work titled Inside Me is kind of an original poem. So let's take a look inside the very lovely Paulette Cunningham. She's contestant number 6.
Touch the stars and have the very best of things and travel the world afar. But at times I had to run and hide so others could not see the hurt, the pain, the emptiness so deep inside of me. But hope was always here inside and always on my mind. For I found hope was the reason for all of my troubled times. Having now the understanding of life and all it has to offer, my walk, my talk, my thoughts have changed. My life is so much brighter. Now I laugh. I smile, I sing a lot, for reasons I just can't explain. So happy, so glad, so grateful that my life is not the same. I thank God above for life, love, and oh so many, many friends. I am assuring you now that I am cherishing my life until the very, very end. So twinkle, twinkle, so twinkle, twinkle, little star. Thanks for reflecting your light on me and shining your big, beautiful, bright light on the star inside of me. To the stars.
You know, this is always interesting because everybody has their own thing. And I think the next lady that you're going to meet is very, very interesting in what she's going to do. I think you're going to really enjoy this one. Our next contestant, of course, will be showing what we call style and grace. And I don't think we've ever done this one before. This is kind of unique. This is a modeling situation where a lady is going to show you how well she can model. And she's going to be modeling to Michael Jackson's Liberian Girl. You like that? So, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like for you to give a warm, warm welcome to Miss Senior DC's contestant number 7, Miss Hadia Mohammed. Let's give it for her.
Ooh, babe. All right. scene. And she says, do you love me? And he says so honestly,
told you it was creativity, and that's what we're getting today. These guys are doing it. These ladies are doing a wonderful job, I think, really. I am amazed, I tell you. And the energy. Remember what I said, age ain't nothing but a number. Remember that. Write that down, okay? All right, this is our final contestant in the talent segment of the pageant. This is unique as well. She will be playing the saxophone. Precious Lord, Take My Hand. Happens to be one of my favorite songs. Gospel song. The lyrics were written by Reverend Thomas A. Dorsey, who also adopted the melody. So I want you to listen and enjoy Elinthia Smith, contestant number 8. Let's give a round of applause.
Volunteer organization made up of dedicated and concerned senior ladies, 60 years and older. We volunteer at schools, nursing homes. We give showcases which show our talent when we are invited by various churches, organizations, and clubs. We also serve as hostesses for the mayor's special events for seniors. Each December, we gather toys, clothes, shoes, coats for our Children of Promise Christmas Tree program. Members, friends, and many of the stores have been so wonderful to participate with us. This year, we had our first annual prom gown giveaway. Many stores donated brand new gowns that have never been worn. They took them right off the rack for the young ladies of the DC Public School. Not only did they get a fabulous gown, but they also, many of them, found shoes to match, jewelry, and were given certificates to have their nails done and their hair fixed. What a wonderful time we had that day. We all had to see the happiness on the faces and the love and appreciation of the mothers and fathers who came with their daughters. Around this time of year, this is one that you can participate in if you are 60 and older. We begin inquiring and looking for ladies 60 years and older. Come and join us and be a contestant for next year's pageant. Won't you come, share your talent with us and be a 2018 Miss Senior DC pageant contestant? You may call our director, Mrs. Darlene Nowlin, at the Office of Aging, and she will be more than happy to give you any information you require. And so I say thank you, have a blessed day, and may God be with you all.
In just a moment, I think this is one of the classic examples of why this pageant is here and why we are here today. And I think you're going to really feel good when you see how beautiful these ladies are. We'll be judging the evening gown competition and philosophy of life, a portion of this contest.
To live. And during these times, you face many experiences and challenges, but they've made me a stronger woman. My faith has helped me overcome many trials and tribulations. I'm a survivor, not a victim. And when the curtain goes up,
people are always asking me, why do I smile all the time? A smile is free. A smile is universal. A smile can lift you up. You never know when you may meet somebody. They might be hurting inside. They may need that smile. Don't let the world change your smile. Let your smile change the world. My legacy is to change the world one smile at a time.
God for the precious gift of life. I strive to be positive in every aspect of life. And my joy is to live, love, and to embrace life, imparting upon my legacy a noteworthy life of commitment, dedication, and faith in God as they too journey through this gift of life. and desire that inner peace that resides in all of us. My inner peace is compassion, cheerful, grateful, harmonious, untroubled. Take the time to discover your inner peace and embrace it.
I have lived in this body for 72 years. And in that time, I've been lied on, lied to, cheated on, brokenhearted, and I broke a few hearts myself. But I realize I still have a journey. I have hills I haven't climbed, flowers I haven't smelled, I've got challenges I haven't met. And since God knows his daughter well, I'm gonna live what time I have out left, out loud and on purpose. And if you don't believe me, just watch.
Challenges all will take you on a journey up and down hills where you may fall many times. But don't quit. Wake with a purpose, wake with a smile, amaze yourself, laugh out loud, be bold, be optimistic, take chances, love to no limit, and above all, find the joy in your life.
No more daddy's little girl. We all have our moments, beautiful inside and out. I live by the golden rule. You must enjoy life, yes. Live, laugh, and love. At the age of 63, I wouldn't have it any other way.
Life, live life to the fullest. It's a tale, a mystery that unfolds before your very eyes. Find your passion, dare to do the impossible, and most of all, love to learn.
Without a doubt, ladies and gentlemen, our ladies have demonstrated pure elegance. Let's give the contestants another round of applause. And this, of course, completes our judging portion of the contest. The next lady that I'd like to introduce, as we take a moment here, has just been a lovely, lovely representation for this whole pageant. So I'd like to bring out Miss Senior DC, Billy Laverne Smith, to do her final walk and a farewell address. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Senior DC, Billy Laverne Smith.
Greetings, everyone. Thank you for supporting the Miss Senior DC Pageant 2017. That's this one, 17. This has been the most amazing year of my life. The experiences I've had, the places I've been, the people I've met, the friendships I've developed, and the love and respect that I've received and given. It's been truly overwhelming. I didn't know what to expect this very day last year when I received this crown and the sash, which I forgot to put on. And that may be a good thing, because I may have been tempted to abdicate the throne. But on the other hand, no one told me about the awesome, amazing Ladies of the DC Cameo Club that would become my sisters and my mentors. No one told me about the wonderful 9 other ladies who some called my competitors, but I called my sister girls. No one told me about the hundreds of fantastic, seasoned residents of the District of Columbia. No one told me that my life would be forever changed for the better. I have learned some amazing lessons this past year. I learned to step out on faith, go places I had never been before, sometimes by myself. Met and conversed with great people from all walks of life, from the DC mayor and my council person to seniors in other wards. I've marched in 4 parades. I've served as mistress of ceremony for 2 programs. I've brought greetings from the Cameo Club and the DC Office on Aging numerous times. I've visited senior wellness centers, been invited to birthday parties, including that for a 100-year-old DC resident. On the other hand, one of my favorite activities has been interacting with just ordinary folks like me. It tickles me sometimes when I hear, "There's the Queen, there's Miss Senior DC," and I'm asked, "May I take a picture with you?" But then I just laugh and talk and listen to their amazing stories. That's the real reward of being Miss Senior DC. As a representative and advocate for seniors, I've received so much assistance. Members of my court and the DC Cameo Club have been with me from the very beginning of my reign to this very day. Seniors that I have met across the city have shown support and appreciation for the senior movement. My church, Trinity AME Zion Church, and my pastor and my members have gone right along with me and attended the same programs I did. I know who that is. My sorors of Delta Sigma Theta Sorority, Incorporated, have been my fortitude. My family and friends have had my back the entire time. Even strangers have shown their appreciation and helped me along the way. What more could I ask for? I give the utmost credit to my mentors, Sandra Bears, Miss Senior DC 2005, and my predecessor, Queen Wendy Bridges, Miss Senior DC 2015. They have gone overboard to help me through this year, and I can never adequately express my thanks, appreciation, and love to them, as well as to all the former queens and the member of the DC Seniors Cameo Club. And I can't leave out Darlene Nowlin and the DC Office on Aging, who do such amazing work. Thank you.
glad that you're here to see this great show. These women have worked for about 2 months now to make this show for you, and so I'm so glad that you're here to do that and to witness it. I'm sorry. I want to call back out to the stage Miss Senior DC, Billy Laverne Smith. We have an award for you. Miss Billy Laverne Smith, Miss Senior District of Columbia 2016 pageant theme, Keys of Life. I hope all of you were there. Thank you for serving as our gracious ambassador, Miss Senior District of Columbia Planning Committee, Darlene Allen, District of Columbia State Pageant Director, and the District of Columbia Office on Aging.
Thank you.
She has been a great ambassador this year. She has stepped out of her comfort zone and done some things that she probably would not have done if we had not asked her, and we are so proud of her. She has had a great year.
It has been.
She's been all over the city, in each ward of the city, and met so many different people, and we are just
wonderful
so proud.
People.
Thank you.
Don't go now.
There's some other people in the audience that we forgot to announce, so we want to make sure we acknowledge them. Miss Debbie Miller, Miss Senior Virginia USA, 2016-2017, and Miss Transatlantic. And also Miss Karen Moore, Miss Senior Maryland 2017. And we also have the American Classic Woman of the Year, Miss Vinay Lagan. Thank you. Are there any other queens or anybody else we failed to mention? Anybody? No? Okay. I want to thank you all again for coming. We had a great year this year. And we had a lot of people who worked on this committee. I can't name names because we'll be here all night, but they worked very hard, volunteered their time, and we really appreciate it. And want to make sure that I announce the assistant pageant director, Miss Ann Thomas, and also the pageant chair, Miss Sandra Bears, and our choreographer, Miss Monica Carroll. Didn't she do an excellent job with the MC Steppers? And our judges chairperson, Ms. Sandra Hunter. And also our logistics chair, Ms. Stacy Dweet. But I don't want to name any more names, I know, because you get into trouble that way, so I won't do that. But I thank you again for coming. I know the judges have a hard task, and we thank all of them for being here as well. Thank you so much.
Okay, I promise you I won't do a Steve Harvey. You know what happened, right?
Yeah.
Not all my time, no. Remember, age ain't nothing but a number. Everybody say that one more time. Age ain't nothing but a number. Hey, you got that. Thank you. Right now, you're going to really like this next performance, so I'm going to let Sandra Bears do the honors, the MC Steppers to perform. Sandra?
As the story continues, I always knew I had it in me. I live and breathe what I believe. What you discover inside yourself is life and what life has to offer. Remember to value and the depth of who you are as a person, the greatest.
Heard about the party now, just east of Harlem. Dougie gonna be there, but you got to call him. Even the soldiers need a break sometime. Listen to the groove, y'all. Let it unwind your mind. No intoxication, let's see what I see. Dancing hot and sweaty, right in front of me. Call me what you like, I'm a woman I be. This is just another one of God's gifts, musicology.
was backstage talking to one of the coordinators of that group, and they said, those ladies rehearse a lot, and they work so very hard. Are you guys ready for the results of everything we've been doing tonight? Mm-hmm. Okay, well, let's do this. Let's bring the contestants back to the stage, and we will start with contestant number one, Rebecca Ann Washington. Let's welcome her to the stage. Followed closely by contestant number two, Patricia Raglan. And now, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the stage, contestant number three, Frances Curtis Johnson. And the fourth contestant, Juanita Patterson. Miss Patterson. Contestant number five, Dr. Julian Andrews. Contestant number six, Paulette Cunningham. Contestant number seven, Hadia Muhammad. Contestant number eight, Cynthia Smith. Let's give them all a round of applause. Okay, this is the moment we've all waited for. Someone said, uh-oh. Now we will present the award for the best interview. The ballots have been sealed, and I will now announce the winner. For best interview, the winner is Frances Johnson. Congratulations. Next, ladies and gentlemen, we will present the award for the person with the best talent presentation. The winner is Patricia Raglan. Next, we have an award for the contestant who sold the most tickets, and I think an advertising, of course. So I think this is a fantastic thing that this person did. The Best Salesperson Award, the winner is Frances Johnson. The next award is for the Best Evening Gown. It goes to Patricia Raglan. And as you know, in our pageants, all the contestants have someone that they think is Miss Congeniality, and the next award goes to that person. Her name is Hadia Muhammad. Miss Congeniality. And now for the moment you've all been waiting for, as well as I have, I'm going to read the results of the envelope, starting with the second runner-up. The second runner-up for Miss Senior DC for 2017 is Patricia Raglan. Okay. Maestro, can I have a drum roll, please? First runner-up, Dr. Julian Andrews. Winner. Okay, with great anticipation, ladies and gentlemen, I want you to stand on your feet and welcome 2017, the Senior DC I get confused, but she's going to be our reigning queen. She's a wonderful, wonderful person. Are you ready? Yes. Princess Johnson!